isotopes, minions, honey, nuclear power plants, and how they are all related. Here we go. This is Chemistry Pitch, and we're going to define what an isotope is and why they are important. But first, let's talk about minions. Minions have a lot of the same traits: yellow bodies, glasses, black gloves, and whether short or tall, they have a generic Twinkie shape to them. And yet, they have differences too. Different number of eyes, different heights, different hairdos, different personalities. They are the same, and yet different. That really reminds me of isotopes in chemistry. What is an isotope? Isotopes were unknowingly discovered in the early 1900s when ionized atoms were shot through an electrostatic field, and it was found that some atoms of the same element were deflected differently than expected. That was totally perplexing because they were all the same element. Shouldn't they act the same way? It wasn't until James Chadwick discovered the neutron in 1932 that scientists could fully explain why the deflection was different. You see, if isotopes had more neutrons, they would be deflected less since they were heavier. Isotopes with less neutrons were deflected more since they were lighter. We had discovered atoms of the same element that had different masses. Isotopes are atoms of the same element but having a different number of neutrons. And as a consequence, different mass numbers. Minions are a great analogy for isotopes. They are the same but different. Isotopes are the same element but different. Isotopes of the same element still maintain basically the same chemical properties. Some physical properties can differ, however, like density or evaporation rate. The term isotope was coined in 1910. Iso, meaning the same, topos, meaning place, describing how we had different atoms of the same element occupying the same place on the periodic table. What do isotopes have to do with the periodic table? Isotopes are all over. The decimal numbers on each element is actually an average of all the isotopes on Earth. We call it the average atomic mass. What is average atomic mass? That's beyond our scope right now. I'll have to save that for another video. Do you like honey? Honey is an expensive product, and the producers are sometimes tempted to try to dilute it without people knowing. Isotopes can help identify whether or not honey is pure or not. The sugars in honey have a lot of carbon atoms. When studying the purity of a sample of honey, food inspectors specifically look for the isotope carbon-13. What is carbon-13, and how does it differ from the regular isotope of carbon? Isotopes are common for almost all the elements. For carbon, 99% of the carbon atoms on Earth are carbon-12, that is, carbon atoms with 6 protons and 6 neutrons, making up a mass number of 12. And while there are trace amounts of carbon-11 and carbon-14, the vast majority of the other 1% of carbon on Earth is carbon-13. That is carbon atoms with 6 protons and 7 neutrons, making up a mass number of 13. It has a different number of neutrons than the dominant carbon-12. If you are curious about what isotopes exist for each element on the periodic table, I find Wikipedia is an excellent source of information for this type of thing. Go ahead and look up a few elements. You might be intrigued. But back to our honey inspection. Food inspectors can use carbon-13 to detect whether a honey sample is pure or not. Honey has an unusually high amount of carbon-13 due to how carbons are processed during photosynthesis in the flowers that honeybees choose to pollinate. If honey has less carbon-13 than expected, inspectors would have reason to suspect the honey has been adulterated with cheaper syrups like corn or cane sugar syrup. How stable are the nuclei of isotopes? Some isotopes are very stable, while others are not stable and can be radioactive. A nucleus with too many neutrons or too few neutrons can make it unstable. Scientists have studied the stability of nuclei of different isotopes. Do you know what the most stable isotope in the universe is? After looking at many combinations of protons and neutrons, we have found that the most stable combination for a nucleus in the universe is 26 protons and 30 neutrons, which is the element... Wait, you should be able to figure this out. Can you look at the periodic table and figure out what element it is? The key here is 26 protons, its atomic number. Yes, iron. Iron-56 has just the right combination of protons and neutrons to make it the most stable nucleus of all time. Seems fitting based on how useful that element has been to us over the millennia. Sometimes different isotopes of an element can be more useful than other isotopes. 99.99% of the hydrogen found on Earth is hydrogen with no neutrons. 0.01% of the hydrogens on Earth have an extra neutron, making it hydrogen 2, often called deuterium. Deuterium is critical in some nuclear power plants, like those found in Canada. Water is made of a single oxygen chemically bonded to two hydrogen. When those hydrogen atoms are replaced with a deuterium isotope, hydrogen with an extra neutron, they become what's called heavy water. It is this heavy water that can be useful in nuclear reactors. Do all nuclear power plants use heavy water? No, but Canada has perfected their style of nuclear power so much that they exclusively use heavy water reactors, reactors they call CANDU reactors, which stands for Canada Deuterium Uranium Reactors. There are advantages to their style of nuclear reactors. One of the biggest advantages is that you don't need enriched uranium. You only need naturally occurring uranium. Many countries like this advantage and have purchased CANDU reactors to use in their own countries. Countries like India, Pakistan, Argentina, Romania, China, and South Korea have purchased CANDU reactors. Why does the CANDU reactor need heavy water to run? Nuclear power plants are an interesting story of isotopes. Uranium and plutonium are the main elements used in nuclear power plants. CANDU reactors use uranium. The main isotopes of uranium are uranium-238, which makes up 99.3% of natural uranium, and uranium-235, which makes up 0.7% of natural uranium. While other uranium-based nuclear power plants require an enriched level of easily fissionable uranium-235, CANDU reactors can use the natural uranium with a percentage of uranium-238 and uranium-235 just the way it is. During the fission of uranium in these reactors, extra neutrons are produced. A way to manage the neutrons during the reaction is essential to keep the nuclear reaction going and to keep it from getting out of control. The main neutron regulator in most nuclear power plants in the United States are control rods that are inserted into the nuclear reactor to slow down the reaction as necessary. With a CANDU reactor, however, they use heavy water to regulate the neutrons. The extra neutron available in deuterium gives heavy water unique abilities to moderate how neutrons work in the reactor. CANDU reactors are a beautiful example of isotopes in action. Uranium isn't the only radioactive isotope that is useful to us. Hydrogen with two neutrons, called tritium, is used in self-luminous watches, exit signs, and firearm sights. Americium-241 is a radioactive isotope used in smoke detectors. Carbon-14 is used to date artifacts that are thousands of years old in archaeology. Cesium-137 and cobalt-60 are used to treat cancer. Plutonium-238 is used as a power source for space probes. Isotopes like Minions are useful because of their differences. We use isotopes all the time and will continue to use them. Thanks for joining us, and hopefully you understand better now what an isotope is and why they are important.